Hardly a week goes by without disruption to train services in the southeast because of vandals. Most incidents are minor, but the West Ealing crash shows what can happen. For drivers, running into objects on the line has become a worrying prospect.
We found loads of stuff on the line between Sea Green and Beaconsfield. We collected it all up and put it in the cab of the unit, and there was concrete and bits of metal and supermarket trolleys, all kinds of things. So it does happen occasionally, yes.
How worrying is it for a driver?
Well, it must be worrying, mustn't it?
And there's growing concern at the amount of rubble and objects left lying along railway lines, which can make it easy for vandals to derail trains.
We're now travelling between Ealing Broadway and Paddington. The entire stretch of line is littered with masonry and other objects which could easily be thrown on the track.
British Rail say the matter will form part of their inquiry into the West Ealing crash. They're keen to stress the lengths they've taken to tackle the problem. Special police trains are run on problem lines to catch vandals, and there's a special video warning youngsters of the dangers. Meanwhile, police this afternoon set up a special incident room to help catch those responsible for deliberately causing Sunday's crash. They've already received dozens of calls.
So far, we're certainly into three figures with the response we have, and many of those inquiries may well prove to be fruitful, but I still would prefer people to continue phoning in if they honestly believe they have something to offer.
Meanwhile, the operation to clear the wreckage at West Ealing is well underway. The locomotive and carriages have been moved. The major job now is replacing half a mile of damaged track.
Tonight, Western Region services are still seriously disrupted. Most local trains are cancelled, but there is a half-hourly shuttle running between Paddington and Reading. Intercity services are running. They're delayed on average by about 10 minutes. Western Region hope things will be back to normal by tomorrow, but they say there may still be some delays. This is Mike Pearce at Paddington Station for Thames News.